We have formed a quorum for this meeting, the meeting of the panel on security. Item number one on the agenda, election of chairman and deputy chairman. In accordance with our rules of procedure, paragraph 77, bracket 6, if a member is chairman or deputy chairman of an advisory bodies appointed by the government with similar terms of reference as the panel, then that member cannot be chairman or deputy chairman of the security panel. So let me now, and also under House Rule 77, bracket 7, no member shall be chairman or deputy chairman for more than one panel. And now we need nominations. A valid nomination has to be made by a member, seconded by another, and accepted by the nominated member. I nominate you, Mr. Gary Chan. As I have been nominated as a candidate and I accept it, I will now invite Mr. James Toh to preside over the remaining procedure. All right. Do we have another nomination? If not, I'll count to five. One, two, three, four, five. I declare that Mr. Chan Hak Kan has been elected chairman.
多謝大家的支持，我會根據我們的會議的守則盡量去主持和做好我們的會議。接下來我們就選舉委員會的副主席，請問有哪位同事提名？是莫乃光議員。是我提名。涂謹申議員。是。哪位和議？歐樂軒議員和議。
就涂謹申議員是否願意接受？
我接受。
好啊，就涂謹申議員願意接受嘅。咁而家問有冇第二位提名？我同樣都係數五聲啦嚇，五、四、三、二、一。由於咧冇其他嘅提名咧，我宣布啊涂謹申議員咧係自動當選我哋保安事務委員會嘅副主席嘅。好啦，同事們政府主席的選舉都已經完成了，請大家留意我們去到議程的第二項，就是2018-19年度會議的會議日期。一般來說，我們事務委員會都會在每個月的第一個星期二下午2:30舉行的。咁咧喺大家文件上面咧，秘書已經將未來一年嘅會議嘅日期咧係俾咗大家啦。不過咧就有幾日咧係同公眾假期係撞咗嘅。咁譬如話1月1號啦、2月5號啦、7月2號。
There's some clashes with public holidays. So for the 1st of January 2019 meeting, it will be changed to the 8th. For the 5th of February, it will be held on the 15th of February, and then for the 2nd of July, it will be held on the 9th of July instead. Any objection? If not, then we would do this. There's a special meeting to be held on the 29th of January, a Tuesday, from 2 to 4 p.m. That's the annual regular briefing on law and order situation in Hong Kong by the Commissioner of Police. It would be for the meeting held on the 29th of January from 2 to 4 p.m. Next item, AOB. The next meeting will be held on the 2nd of November at 8:30. And we'll be hearing briefings from the Secretary for Security and the Commissioner of ICAC. And the Security Bureau will also like us to take up the discussion of a manpower proposal in relation to the non-refoulement claims. So the meeting will be extended to last until 11 a.m. Any objection? All right, as in line with past practice, the floor is now open for members to make suggestions on discussion topics so that I can take them up when I meet the Secretary for Security. Mr. Siu Kachun, Mr. Lam Chuk Ting, Ms. Priscilla Leung. So 1 minute for each member. Mr. Chen Chi Chun. The government has lost the final appeal of a QT case. A press release has been issued that the policy on dependents on the admission of the dependents will be changed. I hope we can be given a chance to have a discussion. Let's put this on the list of outstanding issues. Well, I'll raise it when I meet the administration. Chairman, when you and the Deputy Chairman meet government officials, please remind them to look into the contingency plans to address natural disasters and the aftermath of such tragedies. And we have also got a private member's bill, the tragedy or disaster bill. Some members from the pandemics have asked me to convene a meeting on the measures to deal with the aftermath of the disasters. And we have asked the administration to come to brief us and answer questions. As for your private member's bill, we would arrange a briefing and a chance for members of the panel to express views on the bill. Mr. Siu Kachun, I have two issues to propose. First, cyber crime. We have seen an increase, 30% increase in the past year, so we would like to know how the police are tackling this. Secondly, 2 days ago, the Society for the Rehabilitation of Offenders published a report saying that for elderly offenders, usually they commit the offense due to dementia or other medical conditions regarding to the dementia. Mr. Lam Chuk Ting, the commissioner of ICAC is about to retire. The two assistant directors are about to retire, and the four are also approaching retirement age. So there may be a problem with a succession of senior officers in the commission. We'd like to have a chance to discuss it. Ms. Priscilla Leung, recently we have seen the crimes committed by the torture claimants in the community, and we have heard about possible legislative amendments. And also, there's nothing we can do when Hong Kong people committed crimes on the mainland or in Taiwan and then return to Hong Kong. So what we would like the Security Bureau to talk to us about this. Actually, this is already handled by a group led by Ms. Elizabeth Kwok. As for the mutual legal assistance, is also on the list. Maybe it would be better for the matter to be discussed at the AJLS panel. Well, I raised this because the members of the AJLS panel said it should be taken up by this panel. So perhaps we should arrange a joint meeting. Mr. Au Lok Hin, the UN has got certain views about our public order ordinance, and in the regular scrutiny of reports submitted under ICCPR, have mentioned something about this ordinance. Well, I'd like to have an agenda item put on the table so that we can discuss the recommendations made by the UN body in respect of the POO. I understand that Mr. Jiang Kuo-kun has talked about intermediaries or financial institutions, but recently the nature of the activities have experienced some changes. With the economy so uncertain, I hope this can be taken up as an agenda item expeditiously. Ms. Elizabeth Kwok, two issues. First is smart security measures. We have the Smart City Initiative, so it's important that we have a smart security systems and measures. It should be launched out on the fullest possible extent. And I've forgotten the second issue. I've forgotten this. I'll let you know. I'll write to you afterwards. All right, if you have issues that are close to your heart, by all means, inform us at the close of every meeting or write to the clerk of our panel. All right, last item, AOB. There's nothing in the AOB. Meeting's adjourned. Thank you.